And now Mark McGwire. His historic chase continues. One home run shy of Babe Ruth. Two shy of Roger Maris's 61. He's facing a Reds team that hasn't allowed a McGwire home run all year. And on a fail, they can't say it anymore. 60! And now Mark McGwire is one home run away from tying a 37-year-old record held by Roger Maris.
I wonder what Dad would have thought of all this.
It's weird. In some ways, it's like the best season Dad ever had.
Yeah, he's not even here to see it.
You guys ready to go?
Just waiting for Mom.
McGwire's date with destiny rapidly approaches. Thoughts of 1961 when two Yankee teammates and that great home run race, Roger Maris, Mickey Mantle, chasing another Yankee great, Babe Ruth. 61 home runs in a season, a record they said would never be broken. And as the Maris family makes their way to St. Louis to witness history, you're all invited to watch Mark McGwire continue this home run chase. A wave to the crowd of fists in the air.
I'm ready. Let's go.
Folks, don't go anywhere. The way he's swinging the bat, this could happen soon.
Maybe he won't do it.
Come on, Susan. There's 25 games left.
Well, if he does do it, he better do it this weekend. I don't want to follow him around for the next 2 weeks.
Mom?
Mom?
Mom,
what is
it? Matter?
I can't catch my breath. But the doctor said it wasn't a heart attack. It's my arrhythmia. I'm fine, really, Susan. I slept well. I feel great this morning.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Kev. What's that?
It's Dad's bat. It's the one who hit the 61st to it.
The Hall of Fame sent it to the hotel. They said Mark wanted to hold it.
Can I see it?
The family of Roger Maris also came to town. Pat Maris, the widow of Roger Maris, had to be hospitalized upon arrival. That ball is gone, and it's fair. It is a home run, number 61. He has tied Maris.
One more to go for Mark McGwire and his rendezvous with history.
Those of you who have been watching the Houston Astros and the Cincinnati Reds as Matt McGwire looks on, wondering if this is the at-bat. Tuesday, September 8th, and Mark McGwire moves one place in front of Roger Maris.
Oh, come on, Bob. It's opening day.
Hello there, everybody. This is Mel Allen with Phil Rizzuto coming to you live from Yankee Stadium, where we're just about an hour away from opening day of the 1961 season.
And Mel, I still get goosebumps out here, even in a suit, I'll tell you.
I'm sure you do, Phil.
Absolutely. A new Yankee skipper, Ralph Houck, got some team. What with Yogi and Ellie Howard behind the plate, chairman of the board, Whitey Ford, Moose Scowron over at first, and up the middle, we got Richardson and Tony Kubek, and the glove cleat Boyer at third. Not to mention those bombers, Roger Maris and the great Mickey Mantle.
Who's that?
How's this feel, man?
Feels good, yeah. Hey, Whitey, look at that. She likes to read to the blind.
She's not your type, Slick.
Yeah, I like women with small hands. Makes my dick look bigger.
Yeah, right.
Hey, Mick. Did you read Sam Simon's column today?
No, you know I don't read that shit. That son of a bitch been after me since day one. What's it say?
All I wrote is he should be coming into his prime. Instead, he's had two off years in a row. You're the owner of the team, Dan. You know what I'm talking about.
For Christ's sake, Sam, he hit 40 home runs last season. Every guy in the league would kill to have that kind of off year.
It's pretty amazing the guy can play at all, considering how much pain he's in.
Maybe if he took better care of himself, he wouldn't be injured so much. Hey, you should be thanking me for leaving that out of the paper.
Mickey, how you doing?
How you doing, Mick?
Hey, Mick. Mick, you're in the cage.
Opening day, big guy. Opening day.
Mix up.
You can write what you want, Sam. The fans love this guy. They love him.
What the hell does he eat?
Christ, he's unbelievable.
I've been covering this guy 10 years. He still puts me on the edge of my seat.
Oh, look at this. Mr. Ambidextrial.
Ambidextrial?
Ambidextrial, you know, that side, this side. Uh-huh. See you now. Mick, you gotta concentrate. You're not concentrating. 90% of the game is half mental. Remember that.
Did you see that catch? I'm telling you, this kid may be the best right fielder in the league.
That's because it was Mantle.
Oh, come on, come on. Maris works hard every day. You're like a little chipmunk running around looking for nuts.
Look, Maris comes over from Kansas City, first year with the team. He beats Mickey out for the MVP, closest vote in baseball history. You're telling me Mantle wouldn't be pissed off that Maris doesn't have something to prove?
I don't speculate, Artie. I write what I know.
Look, with all due respect, Milt, I don't have a regular column. There's 15 papers in this town. We can't all write the same thing.
Thanks, Rick. Kids up to see the pop get his big award?
Yeah, just Pat and Susan. Yeah, the other ones are too little. They're back in Missouri.
Uh-huh.
Came up for opening day, you know, and then back tomorrow.
Merlin here?
Nah, she back in Dallas with the boys.
She don't like it too much up here.
Who doesn't like it up here?
Your wife, Artie. She likes it down there, you know what I mean?
So, Mick, what do you say? Is there a rivalry between you and the MVP?
Rivalry? Who'd you vote for, anyway?
Well, you know I can't tell you that.
See, Raj, little prick, voted for you.
So, how about the home run record? You think you got a shot at the Babe?
What, are you crazy?
Oh, come on, Mick. With expansion this year, you know the pitching's gonna be thinner.
Come on, best year I ever had, only hit 52.
Yeah, but this year you got 8 extra games on the schedule.
Come on, Artie, it can't be done. Even if they get close, you ain't gonna get nothing to hit.
You're just being modest. You know if you stay healthy, you could do it.
That's just great. One guy's got me all washed up, the other one's got me beating Ruth's record. You guys ought to get together and make up your mind. Tell me how I am so I know how to play.
Hey, what do you say, Raj?
Well, I don't know, Artie. You know, we haven't even played a game yet, so maybe we'll wait and see after we played one.
Look at that. You got the perfect swing for this ballpark.
Well, I don't know, Artie. I think if anybody's going to do it, it's going to be Mickey. You know, he hits from both sides of the plate.
You don't think he got a shot? That short porch out there, huh?
I don't know, Artie. I don't think about that. I'm sorry. You know, I don't know what you want me to say. I don't think about that sort of stuff.
Come on.
Look, I got to get ready for the game, Artie, so I'll talk to you later.
All right, I'll catch you later.
I know I should have talked to you first, but I want you to know I met with some of the writers this morning, and
I told him I'm expecting you to be our leader.
Oh, shit, Ralph. I don't know, you know? I mean, what about Whitey and Yogi?
They've been here longer than me.
You're the heart and soul of this team. Look, I know Casey could be rough on you sometimes, but whatever happened with him is over. I'm the manager now, and this is what I expect. And I'm not just talking about on the field.
Well, nothing gets in the way of me coming to the ballpark, Ralph. You know that.
Well, I know. I know. And I got nothing against blowing off a little steam, but the guys look up to you. And there's a responsibility that comes with that. You got to be the one.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Yankee Stadium. We direct your attention now to home plate. So please welcome the voice of the Yankees, Mel Allen.
Thank you, Bob Shepard. Hello there, everybody. And now, please give a warm welcome to the Commissioner of Baseball, Mr. Ford Frick.
Thank you, Mel.
I died, nobody told
me. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the house that Ruth built. As I stand here this afternoon, it is impossible not to think of the Babe, not to feel his presence here, even now. He was more than a ball player. He was everything that is special about this game. He was everything that is special about America.
I bet I got more pussy than he did.
And so it is a great honor for me to present to you the Babe's widow, Mrs. Claire Ruth. She will present the award for last year's most valuable player. This is Claire Ruth.
On behalf of the Babe, I'm very proud to present this award to another Yankee, right fielder Roger Maris. The Babe would have been very proud of you. Have a wonderful season.
Bottom of the sixth now.
Yankees down 4 runs. I could use a lift here, Phil.
Oh, yeah, and the fans would love to see Mick put one out of here right now.
Oh, yeah, now's the time. All right, here's the windup. Pasquale delivers. Victory call. That'll do it here in the sixth. Tough day for Mickey. The fans are letting him hear it, Phil.
Oh, I'll say, listen to them huckleberries. Jeez.
Well, Bob, does this sound like love to you?
Hey, this is your fault. You guys make him out to be some kind of Superman. Who could live up to that?
Schmuck.
Holy cow, and the Bluebirds are out already.
Boy, oh boy, this is going to be some cannoli of a season, I tell you.
Come on, Sam, what are we talking about? It's one game. We scored more runs than we did. So there is to it. Oh, by the way, I love your column today. Simon says shove it up your ass.
I wasn't finished yet.
Yeah, you were.
Rod, you feeling any extra pressure now after last year?
No, not really, no.
Hap says Mickey's the leader of the team. You got a comment on that?
Well, yeah, he is.
But you're the guy who turned things around last year. A lot of people say you're the one that makes the team go.
I don't know, Artie. I mean, Mickey's been here, what, 10 years and won 8 pennants, 5 World Series? Not too bad. Some grab shower.
MVP, most vacant personality.
Yeah.
Are you gonna live here with Bob?
Yeah, just for the season, and then I'll be back home.
Daddy?
Yeah?
I liked it better when you played in Kansas City.
Yeah, I know, me too. But it'll go real fast, you see.
Susan, you know what? If I don't hit the ball a real long way, I'll be back in Kansas City soon, too.
Why don't you get Uncle Bob to teach you how to juggle?
What?
Just watching you.
Yeah.
Oh, there's steaks for the freezer and plenty of beer, eggs, cold cuts, and, thank you.
Oh, boy, I'm gonna miss you.
It's only 6 weeks till you're home.
Yeah, 3 days, and I'm back on the road again.
You'll be back again in August, right?
Yeah.
Maybe just in time for the baby.
Oh, Pat, I hope so. I want to miss this one.
Well, you're one for three so far. That'll get you into the Hall of Fame. Right?
Yeah. You see, I should be with you. You know, a family should be together.
Well, Roger, and we talked about this. You know, we can't afford two households.
Yeah.
$38,000 goes a lot farther in Missouri than it does New York.
Yeah.
I really want to be near my doctor this time.
You're feeling all right, right?
Oh, I'm fine. I just want to be safe this time. Don't worry about that.
All right. I just hate saying goodbye.
I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
You know who, the fella with the celebrated swing.
Mickey who?
You know who, the one who drives me batty every spring. If I don't make a hit with him, my heart will break in two. I wish that I could catch him and pitch a little woo. I love Mickey.
Mickey who?
Not Yogi Berra.
Who I love.
Everyone, it's going, it is now. How about that?
Mickey.
Hey guys, we're not playing good ball right now. What can I tell you?
Well, you're 25 games into the season and your MVP's batting 200 with three homers.
Don't blame Roger. He does other things to help us win.
But you're not winning, Ralph. Come on, Ralph. Ralph, give me
some. You gotta hang in there. We're losing more than we're winning. I don't think that's good. It ain't good. How could that be good?
We'll turn around. Yo, don't worry
about
it.
We'll turn around. Yeah,
Mickey, better. I know it's still early, but you already got 9 home runs. That's way ahead of Ruth Tate.
You're damn right it's early, and I don't want to hear this shit when we ain't winning.
Are you surprised that fans are getting on Roger?
Yeah, you know, but you can't figure this stuff out. I mean, he'll come around.
Roger, you got a minute?
Look, Mel, you know, I had a tough one out there today. I just... rather not talk about it.
No, I don't want to talk about that anyway. This is just between us. Look, this might just be talk, but the word is you may be traded.
What?
Yeah, you've always been straight with me. I thought you should know.
Trade you? Well, what about last year? Doesn't that mean anything?
Mommy, can I have more juice?
No, the only thing that matters to them is if you're producing now.
Roger. Everybody goes through a little slump from time to time. You know, they're not going to trade you.
Oh, honey, you know, you don't understand.
This is New York. I mean, these rumors don't just come from nowhere. I'm a piece of meat to them. They can do what they want.
You want to see me, Ralph?
Come on in, Raj.
Hey there, Mr. Dutton.
Sit down, Raj.
Yeah.
Obviously... you're not off the kind of start we'd all hoped for. We thought maybe there were some problems we weren't aware of.
No problems, no.
How are things at home?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I understand Pat's pregnant again. Everything all right with that?
Well, you know, she's had a tough time with this one, and we lost one a while back, but... no, I don't think it's affecting my play, if that's what you mean.
You're not worried about hitting 300, are you?
Well, you know, I'd like to get a couple of hits, get myself started, but... it's just not happening, so...
I don't care about your average, Raj. I'm paying you to hit home runs. Home runs and RBIs. You should be swinging for the fences. That's why we brought you here.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, all right, then.
Okay. Relax. Play ball.
Yes, sir.
I'll talk to you later, Ron. Stick around, will you, Raj?
Yeah.
Hey, Mick?
Yeah?
Come here a minute. Shut the door, would you?
What's going on?
Hey,
I want to switch around the lineup, shake things up a bit. I'm going to move Roger to the number three spot, hitting before you, Mick. The way you're swinging the bat lately, I figure he'll see some better pitches that way.
Ralph, you know, I really don't think you need to do that. I'm starting to feel better out there. I'm going to come out of this thing.
Oh, I know. Let's just give it a shot and see what happens.
Whatever's best for the team.
Programs! Get your programs here! Get your programs! Oh, thanks.
Batting second, number 10, the shortstop, Tony Kubek.
Can't figure this guy out. Struck me out twice with an off-speed jump.
The guy, you're thinking about it now.
Yeah.
That's why he's gonna throw you a fastball away.
You think?
I'll tell you something else. That blonde back there's got the biggest tits I've ever seen in my life.
Thanks. Go get them.
Man, the lasagna at that place, they gave me like 16 layers.
That's a good thought. Here
right
it comes,
fielder, Roger.
Okay, Roger steps in. Boy, he needs a hit.
Come on, Rod.
Mantle over there on deck nine. Today because Roger's batting in the third spot. And Kubek leads off first. And there's Richardson inching off second. You know, Ralph Houck has juggled the lineup today to get Maris started. And boy, Roger needs, he's like my car on a cold day, I'll tell you.
Still got that car, huh, Phil? Right, here's Frank Lowry on the mound. He looks Richardson back. And here's the pitch.
Well, there's a line drive to deep right center field. This could be in between them. Richardson will score. It's off the wall. Maris rounds first, digging for second. K-line up with the ball. Here's the throw. Holy cow, line drive double for Roger Maris, and that just could get him started, Mel.
Oh, I hope so, Scooter. Man, did he hit that ball. A screaming line drive, and here comes Mickey.
Now batting, center field Mickey Mantle.
Oh, no, they're going to walk Mantle. Yeah, they're going to put him on. That's good baseball, but I don't have to like it.
Come on.
Well, with first base open, the Huckleberries are going to walk Mickey because he's red hot.
My. And I tell you, Mickey's not going to like that.
So anyway, where was I?
You're talking about this girl.
Right. Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. So I take her back to the hotel, right? We start getting undressed, you know, fumbling around. All of a sudden, she stops. She looks me dead in the eye, and she says, I thought you was a homo. I said, what the hell are you talking about? She says, well, I heard you was a switch hitter. Put on my tab, huh? No, Mickey, shit. You'll be getting them all. Let me get this one. Oh, get out of here. I got it. Hey, a toast to Roger Maris. He's on a hell of a hitting streak because he's getting all them fastballs hitting in front of me.
Hey, I heard DiMaggio's throwing out the first ball tomorrow.
Yeah?
Joe D? Himself.
Oh, shit. Damn it. Get a real
drink. Be right back.
All right.
Shouldn't have said anything.
Yeah. What'd you say? What?
Something between Mickey and Joe?
When Mickey first came up, he's 18 years old. And everybody's saying he's gonna be the next DiMaggio.
No, that he was gonna be better than DiMaggio.
And of course, Joe D didn't like that too much. Because nobody's got more pride than that guy. Nobody.
He wasn't friendly to begin with. Wouldn't say a word to Mick.
Not one word. That whole year, that wasn't right.
And Mickey was never that way.
Man, when I first came up, he was the first guy to take me out with the rest of the guys.
Spring training my rookie year, we were all down in St. Pete. They wouldn't let me eat in the restaurant. So Mickey, he gets his food, comes out to the bus, and he has dinner with me.
You think DiMaggio would have did that?
Of course, he finally talked to him once in the series. Wasn't much of a conversation, though.
I'll say. Remember the 51 series against the Giants?
Yeah, I guess. What happened? What?
DiMaggio's in center, Mickey's in right. So Casey goes over to Mickey before the game. He says, I want you to take everything you can get because the old man can't run like he used to. So Willie Mays gets up, right? He hits a fly ball to right center field. and Mickey takes off.
Could he fly back then? I mean, you never seen a guy run like this.
3.1 seconds to first base. So Mickey's digging for the ball. He's got a beat on it. No sweat. All of a sudden, at the last minute, he hears DiMaggio.
I got it. I got it.
So Mickey pulls up and steps into one of those drains in the outfield. Oh, his knee exploded. Tore it apart.
Here in the bullpen, Raj.
Yeah? So after the game, Mick's dad's there, and he's helping him into the cab go to the hospital, and Mickey leans on him for help. His dad collapses. Turns out he's filled up with cancer.
Then they ended up at the same hospital, lying next to each other. It was a little while after that. His dad died. It was a tough time for Mick.
Get dressed. I need your help.
I didn't want him to try to begin with. I have my own car. But he kept saying he was fine. He's fine, all right. We're weaving all over the road, and he's laughing. See what I mean? I tried to give him some coffee.
All right, fine, sweetheart. Listen, thank you very much. Okay, yes, you can, okay? Bob, please make sure she gets home, okay?
Care.
Hey, Elmer.
It's a hell of a parking job you did there, pal.
Thanks,
come on, come on.
Hey,
where are we going?
Well, we're gonna take
you home. Home? Yeah. I don't want to go home. Let's go to the Copa. Well, we got a game.
You didn't see anything either, though.
Hey, look at my car. Look at my car. Like that. Get up. This is St. Moritz. We've got guests complaining about the noise. He's got girls coming, going all hours of the night. Now, don't get me wrong.
He's stayed with us for many years, and we love having him here. But this, we can't go on doing this. Sooner or later, it's going to end up in the papers. It's bad for the hotel.
Hey, am I in my room yet?
Ooh. Boy, you got some place here, man.
I really appreciate you helping us out here, sir.
Yeah.
Really. I mean, listen. We'll talk to Mickey, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Don't sweat.
Oh. Hey, Masseur. I'm expecting a guest,
mm-hmm.
and his name's Mr. Jack Daniels. Here's a little something for yourself. So you send him right up when he,
Thank you, sir.
Comes over.
Hey, Slick, how come every time you get drunk, it costs me money?
Huh?
Come on, Whitey, just get him in the shower.
Relax, fellas. I'll take care of him from here, okay? I appreciate it. I got
you sure?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, then. All right. We'll see you at the park.
Night, Mick.
I got a big mouth.
Not your fault.
I shouldn't have said anything.
I feel good. Come here.
Joe D's here. I'll handle the writers.
Better not come in right now. You know, it's just not a good time. Just right now.
Right? Here you go, kid. Breakfast of champions.
No, it's going to be a good year. I like this club.
Oh, it's Mickey.
Hey, Mickey.
Hey, Joe.
Hey.
How you doing?
I'm good. You're not feeling too good, huh?
No, I just got a little touch of the flu, but I'll be all right for the game.
Yeah, there's a lot of that going around.
Yeah.
I'm here to throw out the ball. Just wanted to say hi.
Hey, it's good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Take care of yourself, huh, Mick?
Yeah. Okay.
A tough day for Mickey. That's 3 strikeouts.
I'll say.
Hit me! Fucking ball!
Curveball bullshit.
I agree with Roger on this, Moss.
Bob has seen it a million times.
It's been going on for a while, Rog.
Yeah, I know.
Look, Rog, that's Mick. Always been Mick, always gonna be Mick. Don't make a mountain out of it.
What's this, the Geneva Convention?
No, we're just a little worried about Mick.
Why, where is he?
He's in the training room. You know, we're all pretty concerned.
Well, don't be.
Mickey can take care of himself.
Right. Well, he couldn't this morning, Whitey. I just figured we should all watch out for him.
He had a rough night. You know what happens to all of us.
Look, Raj, you only been here 1 year. You don't know Mickey like we know. Okay, you try dragging yourself out there every day with no cartilage in your knee and your shoulder hurting so bad you can't even comb your hair. I mean, the guy's taped up like a mummy. He's still pretty good.
Yeah.
So, no. He's got to go out, try to relax, have a couple of belts. That's what he's going to do. So let's not get riled up about nothing, all right?
I'm not riled up, Whitey. I'm just concerned. I'm not a priest, you know. Just he has a rough one last night, and he has a bad game today. And, you know, I want to get back to the series as much as you fellas do. And can't do that without Mickey.
No kidding. That's for sure.
That's all I'm saying.
Hi, Gus.
Mm-hmm.
Give me another one of these, huh?
Ow!
Hey, Raj. How are you, man?
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing much. Just brain just sliding into second. How you feeling?
Wow. My knees are killing me.
No, I was, you had a pretty rough one last night.
All that? No, I just had a little headache today, that's all. What am I supposed to do, man? Every place I go, even a hotel, say, Mick, you have a drink. Hey, Mick, have a drink. It's a tough town not to have fun in.
No, I can imagine.
You know how it is.
Yeah. Listen, Mick, you know, serving, I got this place in Queens, you know, it's real nice and it's quiet and well, nice place, good neighborhood, you know, and heck, sometimes we cook for ourselves and eat in, and other times we're sending out.
What the hell are you talking about?
Yeah, well, I was just thinking maybe you'd like to come and live with us.
Let me get this straight. I got a big fucking suite at the St. Moritz Hotel, and you want me to move to Queens?
Well, there she is. Pretty comfortable. Yeah, we like it. There's a Chinese place up here, a laundry right next door, deli around the corner. Delivers food anytime we need it. Perfect location, Mick. 15 from the city, half an hour from the stadium.
Well, that was it. Got air conditioning, you know, dining room's in here. Pretty good sized living room. A TV and the stereo hi-fi there.
We got a maid comes in every day, cleans the place up, makes the beds.
Yeah, and then kitchen's back in here, and then the
bedroom's down the hall.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and this here, the other one, you know, lots of closet space, comfortable bed, lots of light.
Uh-huh. I don't get it. There's only two bedrooms.
Yeah, me and Bob were sharing the other one.
Oh, no, fellas. No, I couldn't do that.
No, Mickey, it's fine. Right, Bob?
Oh, yeah, yeah, as long as he pays more rent.
Well, I'm not too worried about that, but, you know, it's,
uh-huh.
Well, that's the tour, pretty much. Yeah.
Did you tell him that other thing?
No, did you?
No, you said you would.
Oh,
tell him.
So, Mickey, you know, it's, you know, Bob and I are trying to keep it quiet here. So, you know, we have a few beers every now and then, but,
What, no bras?
Right.
Right, yeah.
Uh-huh. So, you know, it's not the St. Moritz, but it's quiet, right? There's no distractions and, mm-hmm.
And it's fun. We'll have a good time. What do you think?
Look, Pa, ain't it slick?
Yeah, honey, it was my idea. No, you know how it is at the hotel, all the reporters and the fans all the time, and this is great. Well, just me and Roger and Sir. Hey, you look kind of sexy in that.
No, there ain't no girls here. That's Roger. He's wearing a stupid little girly apron and cooking up some bacon. Rog, say hi to Merlin.
Howdy, Merlin.
Hey. Oh, here's Bob. Say hi, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
See, I'm going to be a real domesticated now. What? All right, I got to go. Breakfast's getting cold. All right, we'll say hi to the boys. Okay. Bye.
So how are your boys doing?
Oh, you know, they're good. They're in school. They're all right.
Say, you ever think of bringing them up here?
Yeah, I tried that once. I was living out in Jersey, but, you know, it's too hard when they're here. I mean, you want to go out after the game. They always want you to drive them all over the place. It gets to be a thing. I mean, I miss Manal. He's just better for everybody in this way.
And there you go, Mick.
What the hell's that?
Roger's special eggs.
That's disgusting.
No kidding.
Well, you don't have to have any, Bob.
Oh, thank you. I'm sorry, Roger, but I'm going to have to pass.
Mick, I'm telling you, don't listen to Bob. Last few times I ate these, I hit home runs. Sorry, Bob. Looks like somebody likes them.
You like them?
No, they're shit. But I'm in a bit of a slump. I'll try anything.
All them eggs.
Daddy's gonna love this
one. So you coming out tonight or hanging in with the wife?
Oh, fuck you.
There it is. The Valentine glass for the M&M boy. Holy cow. Wow.
It's unbelievable. Mantle catches him at 27. Maris comes right back with 28. These guys are really pushing each other.
How come Maris never smiles? He's having the season of his life, the Yanks are winning, and he looks like a zombie out there.
There it is, number 31 for Roger Maris.
Send out a search party for that ball.
How about that?
Your ball? Yeah, but it didn't hurt.
So, M&M boys, what do you think of your new nickname?
I think it's got a real nice ring to it.
Wow, Phil,
that
ball went 500 feet. The blast.
Well, Mick and I have been getting a lot of offers for endorsements, so we thought we'd form this partnership.
You think maybe you ought to cut Mrs. Ruth in on the deal?
Why? She hit a lot of home runs?
Here, Mick.
There it is. Number 34 for Roger Maris. How about that? Mantle crushes one over the Green Monster so hard, and they're buzzing here at Fenway.
Right now you're on pace for 68 homers. You think you got a shot at it?
Oh, I don't know, Milt. You know, I'm still a long ways off.
Getting better pitches, hitting ahead of Mickey?
I don't know. Yeah, I guess.
Well, what if Hawk switches you?
Well, I don't know why you'd do that, Artie. You know, we're both hot right now. The team's doing great, so I don't know. I don't see any reason why you'd change it, you know?
There's a long fly ball to right field. That ball is going, going.
There you are, Mick.
Thanks.
Hey, say, Mickey, shouldn't we be in the field? What are we doing in the stands?
Because these... What are you laughing at? Shit.
Say, Mickey, what are we doing in the stands? Shouldn't we be on the field?
You know, maybe we ought to take a break.
How about that?
Mickey Mantle and Roger Maris.
Here's Daddy.
Mara says 35. Mantle's got 32. We're only in mid-July. They still got 75 games left.
For Pete's sake, Artie, every year somebody has a couple of good months, and everybody thinks they're going to hit 60, all right? Greenberg had 58 with a week left in the season, and he couldn't handle the pressure. Remember
it wasn't
that?
The pressure. They didn't give him anything to hit because he was a Jew.
No, that's nonsense.
Oh, come on. Come on, Milt. They always cool off. You know what? I'm going to bet you $100 neither one of them hits 50. And Maris will probably crap out at 45. You want to bet?
You're on. Put it down. 4 or 5.
No. Figuratively, 48.
Let's remember why I called this meeting. This is the most respected record in all of sports. And I'm concerned that its integrity will be compromised by this new 162-game season. A lot of you are already writing about this, obviously. You're concerned, too.
That's right. Ruth hit 17 that September. Oh, baby, what he would have done with 8 extra games, huh?
Yeah, he might have hit 70. Oh,
that's right.
Okay. Yeah. What if Mantle breaks it on the last game of the season? Is that fair to the Babe?
Listen, I think Mantle's got a shot at it if he stays healthy, but this Maris kid's in a groove like I've never seen.
Yeah, wouldn't that be a story, huh? The crew cut from Fargo becomes the new Babe Ruth. Hey, Roger, how's it feel to be the new home run king?
Pretty good, I guess.
With all respect to these guys, and they are, they're great players. The year that Babe hit 60, he had more home runs than every team in the American League.
What if they both break it? That would really tarnish the record.
What tarnish? What? This is a fantastic story, fellas. Two Yankees playing in the house that Ruth built, both going after his record. It's great for baseball. And if I may be permitted a cliche, records are made to be broken.
If it's broken in the same number of games, eh?
Bullshit, yeah. Sam. Bullshit. You know, when Ruth set his first record back in 1921, he played in 14 more games than the guy who set the record before him. Where was the uproar then? No, I say a season's a season.
We know what you're saying, Milt, but something about this, it just doesn't seem right.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Then there should be separate records. One for each season, right, Ford?
Separate records? What are we doing here?
And we could put an asterisk in it, all right? To show the difference, you know what I mean?
Why not? You know, otherwise it just would not be fair to the Babe.
Gentlemen, thank you for coming. I have a brief statement. As Commissioner of Major League Baseball, it is my determination, given the length of this year's season, that any record broken in more than 154 games will be held as a distinct and separate record.
Hey, Commissioner,
is this ruling directed at the M&M boys and their chase at Ruth's record?
No. This goes for any record.
Any record?
Let me repeat. Any record.
Commissioner, according to my schedule, game 154 is September 20th in Baltimore. Isn't that where the Babe was born?
That's right.
What are you going to do, Raj? I mean, Frick used to be the Babe's ghostwriter. They were really tight.
Yeah, well, it stinks, yo. He's a crock of shit's what it is. Fucking Frick. This is gonna be a circus.
Zoo.
Yeah.
I think Frick's right. If I'd have got it in 155, I wouldn't want it.
Wouldn't want it? How could you not want it?
Not if it had one of them thingamajiggers on the end of it.
How about you, Raj? You think it's right, this asterisk?
I don't know, fellas. Say, Mickey breaks it in 154, and then I pass him later. What are they gonna say if that happens, huh? My mind, season to season.
Then you disagree with Frick's ruling.
Oh, he's the commissioner. It's not my place. I mean, we got 8 extra games. It's true, but, you know, Ruth never had to fly to the West Coast or play in night games. I just think it's harder for us.
Babe hit 343 the year he set the record. You're only hitting 270. You feel bad about that?
No. Why should I feel bad when I'm doing the best I can, Art?
Well, do you think if you focus less on the record, you start hitting for a better average?
I'm not focusing on the record. You guys are.
I'm going to go hit.
Wait, Raj, I got a couple more
questions. Watch out, Artie! Jeez, man, save your life. Look, fellas, all this is bullshit. If one of us has got 50 coming in the last month, come talk to us then.
Maris took a shot at the commissioner by saying that the Babe had it easier.
I did not say the Babe had it easier. You believe this shit?
You gotta be careful.
You think us trying to replace Jesus Christ or something?
Then don't read the Daily News.
What?
Look, in 56, I had 52 home runs. That's all anybody could ever talk about. Ruth this, Ruth that, 24 hours a day. We're chasing a ghost, Raj. You go in that clubhouse, he's there. You're at home plate, he's there. You're in the outfield, he's there, the fat fuck. He's everywhere. We're playing in his house.
And you got it worse. You're playing his position. Yeah, but this is ridiculous, fellas. I mean, I don't give a damn about Ruth.
Well, you better, because he's a god to these people.
Well, screw it then. I'm just not going to do any more interviews.
You can't do that neither.
Then they're really gonna come after you. You gotta give them something, you know?
Well, what the hell am I supposed to give them, Mick?
I don't know. Something about yourself. I mean, I don't know if you noticed, but you ain't that big a talker.
Well, I don't know what to talk about. I don't know what I'm supposed to say.
I don't know, Roz. You know, I mean, I've been living with you most of the season. I don't know nothing about you.
Well, I was raised in Fargo. I played baseball, basketball, football. I married my high school sweetheart. I chose baseball. I played in the minors, came up with Cleveland, faded to Kansas City, and then I came here.
You're right. Don't talk to him.
A real pitcher's duel here tonight. Game tied at one here in the bottom of the sixth. Two outs. Richardson on third, and here comes the big guy, Roger Maris.
Okay, Roger stepping in there, and boy, they're playing him deep. Look at that. The second baseman is actually on the grass. Boy, that's what the outfield used to play me, Mel.
Hit now, Roz. Hit now.
He always hits good against this guy.
Come on, Roz. Knock one out of here.
Come on, get some wood.
Roger hasn't had one in a week, Phil, and I just know he'd love to get a hold of one here.
Can I wish you a happy birthday?
No, here comes the pitch, Phil. Bunt! Oh, the count! Squeeze play! Yeah, Richardson digging for home. Maris going to first. Richardson safe. Safe! Wow, Yanks take the lead 2-1. Holy cow!
Perfect placement. That's a player.
MVP, most valuable player.
Yeah.
Look, fellas, they were playing me deep. We really needed that run.
Come on, Raj. They don't pay you to bunt.
No, they pay me to help the team win, Artie. That's what I do.
Look, Mickey's ahead 43-41. You haven't had a home run in a week. You're falling behind Ruth's pace. Is the pressure starting to get to you there, Raj? Feeling a little gun-shy, maybe?
You know, I don't get it. I strike out, you say I'm swinging for the fences. I bunt, and you say I'm afraid to hit a home run.
You're only a game up on the Tigers. Shouldn't you forget about the record and focus on winning the pennant?
That's what I'm doing.
Have you seen the sporting news poll?
No, Sam, I try not to read the papers.
It says 80% of the fans are rooting for Mickey.
80%. Well, I guess that seems right, yeah.
Why is that?
I don't know. Maybe I'm not a New York kind of guy, Sam. I'm just some dumb redneck from North Dakota.
You think that's the way the fans think of you?
Shit, I don't know how they see me.
Give us something. Come on,
Roger. Could you help me out here?
What's going on here, Milt?
Wild dogs.
All right, boys, that's it for tonight. That's all.
We have a job to do. He's getting a little full of himself, Ralph.
I'm just some dumb redneck from North Dakota. Shit, I don't know how they see me. Maybe I'm just not a New York kind of guy.
Why don't you go back home where you belong? Nobody wants you here. You hick, get out of here. This is the Bronx. This is Mickey's town.
There it is, number 45, Roger Maris.
Oh, they're letting him have it here at Griffith Park. Oh, Roger Maris with his 45th home run, drawing a lot of boos. Boy, these Washington fans are tough. And say that again.
Believe it, crap.
Unbelievable.
M&M fever has gripped the nation. At the White House today, President Kennedy interrupted a press conference to announce that Roger Maris hit his 47th and 48th home runs. That's 7 home runs for Maris in his last 6 games. But with Mickey Mantle right on his heels with 45, the race is still very much alive. Still 6 weeks until Frick's deadline, as the Yankees head to the West Coast to play the new Los Angeles Angels, and Roger Maris just 12 home runs away.
Woo-hoo! Hot damn, honey, this is great news. Oh, wow. So you all right? Everything's fine?
I'm fine.
Oh, good. Oh, 3 more days, I would have been there.
Well, honey, don't worry about it. I tried to wait for you, but Randy had other ideas.
Yeah, I bet he did. Oh, I can't wait to tell the fellas. This is great. So who's he look like?
Well, I hate to say it, but Babe Ruth.
What?
Roger, I'm kidding.
Oh, sorry.
Hey, Raj. Yeah, Raj. I'm a little I heard you got some good here. News. Congratulations.
Yeah.
What's his name?
Ruth.
Very fun.
Oh, that's wonderful,
Raj.
Honey. That's really, really Raj. Great.
Hey, Raj.
Hey, Artie. Do you mind? I'm talking to my wife here.
How much did he weigh? We got a pool going.
You hear that?
Here's someone to hit him a home run tonight.
Oh, honey, if it were that easy, I'd do it every time.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just, you know, I should have been there.
2-0 the count. Here's the pitch.
There it goes. Back to the wall. It's gone. Oh, 50 home runs, and he still has 29 games to break Ruth's record. You know, I think this may be the real newsflash of the day, gang. Roger Maris is actually smiling.
Is that a case for the one I love?
the hell is this, Nick?
Roger, how does it feel to be
big? Sorry, fellas.
This is not Greytown Journal. Do you really think that you can break the record? Do you really think
I don't have a
plan? Can he catch you?
Watch the
Roger, did you watch those books? Do you really think that you
can get this address? How'd you get this address?
I just want the crowd.
Roger, photo, please.
Folks, leave me alone. This is my home.
Daddy!
Hi, sugar.
Daddy, all these people are here for you.
Yeah, I know. It's okay. How'd they get this address?
One of the papers published it.
Which one? Do you know? I'm gonna come and call right now.
Roger.
Yeah.
Would you like to meet your new son?
Oh, of course, Pat. I'm sorry. I just... this reporter's... hey. Oh, look at you. Oh, hi there. He does look like the babe, doesn't he?
Hey, Raj, now this is good. A lot better than egg. You try those?
God, no.
You love them.
Fear, Mickey?
No. No, it's good.
Is he all right?
You know, it's been hard. The pressure and the New York and the papers. But, he's having a hell of a season, that little son of a biff. Pardon me.
3 days just isn't enough. And by the time he's ready to be here, it's time for him to leave.
All right, let's go eat. Come on, Junior. How's the eat?
Great.
Good?
Daddy.
Yeah?
I know who the best baseball player in the world is.
Who's that, honey?
Mickey.
Who told you that?
Mickey.
Hey, she asked.
Well, that's about right.
I'll get that.
Yeah.
Hello? Who is this?
What's wrong, Beth?
Roger.
Who is it?
Thanks very much. I appreciate your help.
You bet.
Well, the detective says 99% is just a prank. You know, somebody's gonna kidnap your kid, they're not gonna call and warn you about it.
That makes sense.
But, you know, just to be safe, they're gonna leave some of the guys here stationed around the house, so...
Do you want me to stay over?
No, it's all right.
No, I'm probably in the way here anyway.
No, Mickey, we really appreciate you being here. Listen, you'd do me a favor, would you?
Oh, yeah, anything, Raj.
Just don't tell anybody about this, you know? Not even the fellas.
Oh, of course.
Just don't want to find it making its way into the papers, you know?
I sure know how to spoil a good time. Good night.
Yeah. I'll see you at the park.
Yeah. Thanks for the... day.
All right.
Hey, Merlin. It's me.
What time is it?
I don't know.
What's wrong?
Well, I just called to say hi to the boy.
Jesus. Mickey, it's 2:30.
Well, I just called to make sure everybody's all right.
Well, they'd like to talk to you more.
That's why I'm calling.
Well, it's a little bit past the bedtime.
Okay, and I'll call back tomorrow. What time to get up for school?
Mickey, it's August.
God, I'm stupid.
Not when these hot dogs are so good.
Good, they're a home run.
Home run? They're a grand slam.
Just like at the ballpark.
M&M hot dogs are a chopper.
Hey!
With American
tough luck, Mick. Shanked it right into the water hole.
Announcing today that it would resume nuclear testing, everyone is concerned about one thing. Who's going to break Babe Ruth's home run record? Roger Maris comes into this crucial Labor Day weekend series against the second-place Tigers with 51. But Mickey Mantle is right behind him with 48. So the only question now is, which M to root for?
Well, no doubt. I mean, it's Mickey Mantle. He's the greatest player that ever was.
Well, I don't want to see Roger Maris break the record. He's always frowning. Besides, Mickey's such a dreamboat.
Hey, dreamboat.
If anyone's going to break the record, I think it ought to be Mantle. Because after all, he's really a Yankee. I mean, the real Yankee kind of guy. I never heard of this guy Maris till last year. And, I don't know, he leaves me flat.
And who are you rooting for?
I want Roger.
Hey, Roger, there
you
go.
Well, because everyone else is rooting for Mickey.
The year Ruth hit 60, his teammate Lou Gehrig hammered 47. They were bitter rivals and barely spoke. As for the M&M boys, I'm told there's also a rift, even a feud growing between them.
Are we feuding? Yeah, I guess so. It's on TV. Oh,
and
fuck
reliable
you, then.
Sources say that to a man, Yankee players are pulling for Mantle. But you didn't hear that from me. From Yankee Stadium, I'm Gabe Pressman.
Who walks the stair without a care and makes the happiest sound? Bounce up and down, the glass of
time for Andy Griffith.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, Bob, are you awake?
Yeah. Sort of.
Is it true? They're saying on TV there about Mickey and all the fellas rooting for him.
Oh, jeez, don't ask me this.
Like, it's all right. I just want to know.
What are you, a reporter all of a sudden? How should I know what anybody thinks? Mickey's been here forever.
Yeah, I know.
Most of the guys, they've known him 5 years, 10 years. They came up with him in the farm system.
Yeah.
Well, I'm not saying that's what it is, you know. We don't talk about it. I don't know. I mean, it's nothing personal if they do. But I'm not saying they do because I don't know. But if they were, it's not personal, you know?
Yeah, sure.
But I don't hear nothing.
Thanks.
Roger! Roger! Please, Roger! Please, you tell my sick kid. He loves you, Roger, please.
Good.
Just put your ex on the ball, please. Just your ex. Oh, God. Thank you. Hey, thank you. We love you. We love you.
Hey, hold on a second.
An ex? What am I, fucking stupid? Fuck you, Maris. Fuck you.
Dan.
Sit down, Ralph.
You wanted to see me?
I just love sitting here in the quiet before a game. What these seats have seen, huh? I've been doing some thinking. I wonder what you thought about changing the lineup tonight.
What kind of change?
Switching Madeline Maris.
You serious? We're a game and a half up on the Tigers, the most important series of the year, and you want me to screw with it? What is this about, the home runs? What, are you reading the fan mail? You want to let the fans manage the team?
The fans pay your salary, Ralph.
Well, you can change the lineup if you want, but not while I'm manager. And I'll tell you something. The right guy is going to break that stupid record.
Number six, Al Kaline.
Well, we got a tense one here, my friends. Top of the fifth in a scoreless game. Two outs, runner on first. Here comes Al Kaline to the plate. But there goes Wood. There's a line drive into the gap. Boy, this could be trouble. It's going to go in between them. Oh, there's Mara first. Makes a great play. Tips it to Mara. And here comes the relay. Holy cow, Roger Maris is one of the best plays I've ever seen to save a run for the Yanks. Boy, the M&M boy's doing it with the glove.
No homers tonight.
We won the game.
You getting a little tired, Raj?
Yeah, I'm getting a little tired of all these questions. That's what I'm getting tired of.
I understand. Just one more.
No, Milton, no, I don't think you do understand. You were there. Moose won the game for us. Ellie's batting 340. Whitey's going to win 20 games this season. Why don't you go talk to them? I'm not the only one on this team.
I got it.
Hey, Raj, one more thing. What's with your new autograph?
What the hell are you talking about, huh? Guy says, hey, Maris, put an X on this ball for my kid, would you? So I sign an X, and then the son of a bitch takes off. You know, I was going to give him a real one. I was just kidding around. Shit. Damn it. We win the most important game of the season, and this is the horse shit that they write about?
Hey, Bob, I'm eating here.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mick. You know, you're not the only one with a bum knee.
I don't know what smells worse, man, your foot or these eggs.
This is horse shit. This is horse shit. I never make a kid cry.
For a guy who don't like the press, you should read a lot of paper.
Yeah, well, Mickey, listen. They want to write about whatever happens on the ball field. I say that's fair game, but this is cheap shot bullshit.
Hey, cheap shots, man. That's part of the deal. In 53, I tried to volunteer for the Army, but I got rejected on account of my knees. The papers started calling me a draft dodger. Don't matter to them what the truth is. I still get booed for that shit.
Well, so what do you do, man? You just get used to it?
No, but you got to. Ow. Now what the hell are you doing,
huh? These hangnails been killing me.
Take it in the bedroom. That's disgusting.
Ow.
Mean-spirited, Roddy.
Hey, I'm not even good enough for people to write about. Why do you read this stuff, Roger? It's not helping you. Look, whether you guys break this record or not, it ain't gonna mean nothing unless we get back to the World Series. You know, they may have to cut my knee at the end of the season. I'm gonna need that $8,000.
I know, I'm sorry about that.
Oh. Now look what you've done.
Probably make it taste better.
Maris already hit his 52nd homer today, and he's looking for number 53. Frank Blair on the mound in the windup. Here's the pitch. Oh, he's got it! That ball is deep to right field. Kaline back to the wall. That ball is going. It is out!
Number 53 for Roger Maris. How about that?
Can you believe this? They're booing him in his own ballpark.
Yeah, I wonder why, Artie.
I don't understand this, Bill. God, there's a couple of huckleberries out there letting Roger know they don't want him to break Ruth's record. Jeez.
Nice talk.
You never know he has 53 home runs.
Damned if he does, damned if he don't. Nice shot, Raj.
Good job, Roger. Good job.
Number seven, the center fielder, Mickey Mantle, number seven.
Seen him get a hand like this before.
He's never been the underdog before.
This is really something, folks. Mantle is at the plate, stuck on 48 home runs, and this Yankee crowd is trying to will him back into this home run race. It's the Yankee fans at their very best. How about that?
Wow, man? And I tell you something else. If he gets a hole in one today, the way he's swinging, it's going to go to Jersey. Mark my word.
Put Blanchard in.
No.
You all right?
Don't ask me twice.
God!
You know, I heard Bunning's pitching tomorrow.
Yep.
He's tough.
Yep.
Win tomorrow, we sweep.
Damn straight. We'll get him.
Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen. Here are the starting lineups.
I always knew I'd end up tying your shoes, Mick. Just figured it'd be in a nursing home, you know?
Oh, fuck, Gus!
How you doing there, Mickey?
I'm okay.
Maybe you ought to sit this one out. I'll move Roger to center for Lopez.
No fucking way, Ralph. I'm playing. What are you looking at him for? It's my arm. I say I'm okay, I'm okay. I'm playing.
Number seven, the center fielder, Mickey Mantle. Number seven.
I can't believe he's out there.
You should have seen him last night.
I know.
Maris leads off first. Here we go. Here's the pitch. That's gotta hurt with that pull muscle in his forearm.
Boy, it hurts me just to watch him, Mel.
Go ahead, try that again.
Sets. Here's a pitch.
That's the gutsiest thing I've ever seen on a ball field.
They love here in the big ballpark.
Hell of a hit, Mick. Put it there, pal.
Can't do it.
A one-armed home run. I can't even eat pizza with one arm.
Overtime, Mickey. Overtime.
What are you doing up?
Well, you know, I couldn't sleep.
Is that Roger Maris?
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have to take a rain check on the night.
Mickey.
I know. How's the arm? You ought to go in early tomorrow, let Gus have a look at it.
No, I'm all right. I'll be fine.
Oh, shit, Mickey. Only four games up on Detroit. You got to take care of yourself.
All right, already. If I need a caretaker, I'll move in with my mother. I know there's a lot of bullshit about this record.
I don't care about this stupid record, Mickey. And shove it up their ass for all I care.
Oh, come on. Give me a break. Why can't you just admit you wanted to?
Oh, shit, man.
Come on, Christ. Have fun with it. Can't have a good time playing baseball, man. Something wrong with you.
Yeah, well, shit, that's easy for you to say, isn't it, Mick?
Oh, come on. Quit feeling so sorry for yourself, huh? I mean, hey, man, I know it's been rough on you, all that stuff. But you ain't exactly helping it too much. I mean, I told you how to handle him, guys. You don't want to listen.
You told me, yeah, you told me a lot of stuff about a lot of different things, and then you just go out and do whatever the hell you want, and nobody says shit about it to you.
Hey, don't get on my case just because everybody else is on yours. It's not my problem.
Right, it's my problem. My problem. You just go out and do whatever the hell you want. Mickey, you ever just stop and think? If you took better care of yourself, you wouldn't be getting hurt all the time. Did you see what you did out there today with only one arm? And tonight you're out screwing around. I mean, how can you do that? You're Mickey Mantle, for Christ's sake.
What's that supposed to mean, huh? What the fuck's that supposed to mean?
I don't know. Maybe you're the one that doesn't want it.
Well, you think you know something about me? You don't know shit about me.
Yeah? Fine.
My dad died when he was 39. Hodgkin's. My grandfather, my uncle, same thing. None of them made it past the age of 45, all right? So I'm going to live my life the way I want. Why don't you get off my back? Go call your wife. Go cry to her about it.
All right, then. The world here. You know, I mean, I can see it. I can see it in their eyes. They're all pulling for Mickey.
How are you two getting along?
What do you mean?
Well, some of the papers say you two are fighting.
Oh, no, they're just stirring up trouble, you know. I hope he hits 80 home runs, Pat. I do.
And you hit 81.
Yeah, of course. I just can't figure it, honey. Why does it gotta be they only have room in their hearts for one guy?
Oh, I don't know, sweetheart.
Boy, sometimes I wish they traded me at the beginning of the year, you know.
Oh, you don't mean that, Roger.
No, I do. I really do.
Oh, I wish I could be there with you.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
I can't kick this goddamn flu. I get it 2 days, it goes away, I get it again. Worse than before, I get the chills. Can't sleep at night.
Mick, this is my doctor. Now, he treats Eddie Fisher, Sammy Davis, a lot of entertainers. He's got this magic shot. I tell you, I've been sick during the day. I take one of these shots. I do the game that night. Now, his name's Max Jacobson. You give him a call, he'll take care of you.
Thanks, Mel.
You bet.
Seems like a good idea.
Hey, Mick, I want you to know I'm not going to take you out of the lineup, but I need you healthy for the series, so if you need a rest, you've got to let me know.
I'll be all right, Ralph. Tell you what, I'll go get this shot, and I'll be good as new.
You take care of yourself. You don't get sick.
You think your boy Roger's gonna do it now that he's falling apart?
First of all, he's not my boy, and if they pitch to him, he's still got a shot.
Nah, it's over. The record's safe. Let's see him out there.
Yeah.
Hey, I look pretty good there.
Yeah. Yeah, you're never better. Jeez.
People are stupid sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, Mick, where I grew up, you went to school, you got married, you worked hard, and you stayed in Fargo for the rest of your life. That was it. I tell you what, that would have been just fine with me, except I could play ball. And my father taught me, just like you.
Huh?
Yeah. He was tough, boy. He pushed us hard. My brother, Rudy, he was a hell of a player. He was far better than I was. We all thought that he was gonna be the one. You know, I don't think I would have even played ball if he hadn't drugged me to the park all the time. But, he got sick with polio.
Oh, jeez.
It was real bad. My father, he just got torn up inside, you know, just parents started fighting all the time, screaming and yelling about everything. But nobody ever talked about it, you know. Not even in the house. Just kept it private. You know, it's nobody's business. Your life is your life.
Yeah.
You're like a movie star to these people, you know.
Oh.
No, you are, Mick. You got away. But me, if I don't want to talk about things and I don't know what they want to hear and I just want to play ball, what does that make me? I mean, does that make me the bad guy?
There is no bad guy, Raj.
Well, I got about 1,000 more that he says you're wrong. I just don't understand why it's so important to them, you know?
Maybe you ought to forget about your mail for a while, you know? Put this shit away.
Nah, I gotta write back the kids, you know? Believe it or not, there's some real nice ones in there from the kids.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday, Raj! From all the gang at Good Shores. Here you go.
Happy birthday, all the kids. Hold on.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Raj.
All right. It's good shit, huh?
Oh, that's good, Mike. Our toots bring out the best.
Man, look at you. You feeling all right? You don't look so good.
I went to the stupid doctor and get a shot for my
flu.
Yeah. Right in my hip. Now my hip's all infected or something. It's swollen up. I don't know what's wrong.
Well, I'll tell you what. You should have somebody
else. Excuse me, fellas. I got a couple of my nieces over at the bar. They're nice, sweet college girls down from Boston. Would you mind taking a picture with them?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks, Raj. Come on, let's go, sweetheart. These are busy men.
Smile!
It's everywhere. But what do I tell my family, my friends?
Well, I hope you tell them it's a crock, because that's what it is.
No, I know, but, you know, I'm in the supermarket and people are whispering. It's humiliating. Why'd you have to go and take a picture with them?
I don't know.
It's embarrassing, that's all.
Well, honey, I don't know what you want from me.
Roger.
I mean, they introduce me, they say take a picture. That's what they do. I don't control the press.
The kids were upset. You know, I was calling you every 10 minutes. I just thought that you were going to be home to talk to us.
Look, I'm sorry, Pat. I, you know, Mickey came up to me after the game.
Yeah, well, you know, I guess it figures one night out with Mickey.
No, Pat, this has nothing to do with Mickey, and I wish you'd just leave him out of it.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have time for this, all right? I don't know how many more times we can go over it. I said I was sorry, and there's nothing I can do about it.
Roger.
Look, you know, I got to get to the airport. I'll call you from Detroit.
You all right, Raj?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Want a beer?
No. Son of a bitch.
What's wrong?
Oh, shit.
What is it?
Look at this, guys.
Hey, Slick, what is that?
Huh? Oh, that's nothing.
Hey, Ralph, Roger won't come out of the train.
Will you give the guy a goddamn break? Did you see what happened out there today?
Come on, Ralph, he's got a responsibility.
You guys are all over him day and night.
This is a big story, come on.
Let the man be for a minute, can't you? If you can't do that, I'll throw you all out, you hear me? Bob, do your job. Move back, will you?
How's it looking back?
A few patches.
God. What the hell's happening to me, Gus?
It's Fischel!
Roger, I need you out there.
I'm not talking, Bob.
Look, they've got a job to do.
What's that? Hurt me and my family?
You only make it worse by not talking to them.
I need you to protect me, Bob. Once! One time! Get those bloodsuckers off my back!
Roger.
No, I'm done, Bob. I'm done. I'm not talking to anybody! You hear me? Let me see a mirror, guys. I don't understand it, you know. The doctor says it's stress. Imagine that. Hair falling out from stress.
Maybe you're in the wrong line of work.
Yeah, maybe. Doctor says to me, you should stay out of pressure situations. You've got me on these relaxing pills.
Oh, fuck doctors.
Excuse me. Coffee and Coke.
Thanks. See? See how I'm taking care of myself?
Yeah.
What are you up to now? 5 packs a day? Can't be too good for you.
No, probably not.
You know, when I first come up, I was under so much pressure from Casey and everybody telling me I was going to be the next Joe DiMaggio. And they gave me number 6, right? Ruth was 3, Gary's 4, DiMaggio's 5, and me, number 6. I hated that, being in line with the other guys. And the press, man, they was all over me. Call me a hillbilly. I mean, I was, you know? I get to New York, I got a $7 suitcase and $8 suit. And my whole town's got 2,000 people in it. Yankee Stadium's got 40 times that. I'm 18 years old, and everybody's expecting me to hit a home run every time I get up to the plate. Yeah. That was killing me. Couldn't hit the ball. So Casey sent me back down to the minors, and I couldn't hit there neither. And finally, I called up my dad and told him I'm quitting. Can't do it no more. No. He said, where are you at? And I told him, he'd come on down in Kansas City is where I was, and throws all my shit in a suitcase and says, okay, let's go. You can come back to work the mines with me the rest of your life. I started crying. He just let me have it, boy. He told me, you know, you being such a baby, you know. I thought I raised a man. You ain't nothing but a coward. Be a man, he says. The truth was, I was lonesome. Scared. Anyway, I started hitting again after that. And came back up, and they gave me number 7. I was glad about it. I hated that number 6. Look, I don't want no more money from that M&M Corporation, and I think that...
Oh, Mickey, listen to yourself.
You're the one who's...
Man, there is no M&M without the two of us, so just, you know...
You're the one carrying us down.
That ain't true, you know.
You do what you want with it, Raj. What I'm saying is, I just ain't getting there. Just can't play no more. And we're out. Done. I'm out of the race. I thought I took pretty good care of myself, too.
You did, man. Damn straight, you did.
Well, anyway, he's all yours if you want him. You go get that fat fuck.
Here's a pitch to Max.
Well, I'd really like you to come to Baltimore if you could, honey.
Oh, I wish I could, but, you know, the kids have been sick and I can't leave them.
Yeah, I know.
But I'll be able to see the game.
Oh, yeah? How's that?
Well, one of the TV stations arranged for me to see the game. Some kind of special hookup or something. I'll be the only one in Kansas City to see you break that record.
Oh, that's great, honey. Oh, that's great. Listen, you know, if you could come to New York next week, you know, you could stay through the series. That'd be real nice.
Oh, I don't know with the kids. That's
hey, Pat. Listen, I really need you there. You know, if you could try it.
I'll try, Roger.
You promise, honey?
I promise.
Okay, then, I gotta go, so, I'll talk to you soon. I love you.
I love you.
Bye. 2 hours away, Roger. How do you feel about
that? And as the Bronx Bombers arrive today in Baltimore, the country braces itself for the showdown. No,
It's not a showdown about the Yankees and the Orioles, but about one man versus history. And that man is Roger Maris. He comes into the game with 58 home runs.
Should I arrange for you to go to Baltimore?
Can he do it? Well, all of America is watching.
So, Milt,
where the hell is Roger?
I don't know. I tried him at the hotel. Nobody knows where he is.
He promised me an exclusive.
What do you want from me? I don't know where he is.
Bob, you know I'm one of the few guys that's defended him all year. Now he stands me up? What's wrong with him? He promises me an exclusive. I got a deadline. Now I'm coming in with nothing. You know, I got 15 local papers and God knows how many nationals I'm competing with. And he doesn't even call. Nothing. Like I don't exist. It's not right.
I'm sorry, Milt. Well, maybe I can get you something with Mano.
I don't want Mano. Mano's not the story anymore. Where's Roger? Where the hell is he?
I swear to God, Milt, if I knew, I'd tell you. Look, I'm sorry. Roger's been under a lot of pressure lately.
You know what, Bob? Spare me that. Everybody's under a lot of pressure. What do you think my editor's going to say to me when I show up there empty-handed? You know, there isn't a man in America who wouldn't give it all up to be playing right field for the New York Yankees. Not a man. And he doesn't understand that. So don't give me any sob story about a guy being paid $38,000 just to play baseball. He's been curt, he's been rude, he's been sullen, he's been moody, and I've been giving him the benefit of the doubt. But I've had it, Bob, because now he's making me look bad.
Milt!
I like cream in my coffee. And I like to sleep late on Sunday, and nobody knows me like my baby. And I like eggs over easy with a flour tortillas, and nobody holds me. Nobody knows me. Nobody knows me like my baby. And she cried, man, how could you do it? And I swore that there weren't nothing to it. But nobody knows me like my baby.
What do you mean you don't want to play tonight? I don't know. Maybe it's time I took a rest, Ralph. I could really use a day off. I know we got a 10-game lead, but if we win tonight, we clinch the pennant. I want to get it over with. Yeah, I know. You know Mickey's out. Bob's leg's gotten worse. He may even need surgery by the end of the year. The point is, I need you in center field. Well, I'll be there for you tomorrow, Ralph. I just, I really feel like I could use a day off. You know, the only reason most of these fans are here is to see you play. You owe it to them to get out there and give it your best shot. I owe it to them? What the hell do I owe them, Ralph? You gotta understand, you mean something to these people, good or bad. And if you quit now, they'll never forgive you. Ralph, they're never gonna forgive me if I do it. Is that what you're afraid of? No, I just want this whole thing to be over. Look, Raj. I'm not a sentimental type guy, you know, but most of us bang around the game for a while and then we're forgotten. Ruth, Cobb, Gehrig, DiMaggio, those guys were bigger than the game. And I know that is not what you want. But right now, whether you like it or not, you're bigger than the game. This is your one shot.
to go out there and show them what you're made of. And that you owe to yourself. I tell you what, why don't you play the first inning, and if you want to come out, you give me a look, and I'll take you out.
All right, then. Sounds fair.
Well, my friends, you couldn't have picked a worse night for Roger Maris. He's got 58 home runs, needing 2 to tie and 3 to break the great Babe Ruth record. But the winds of Hurricane Esther are still swirling through Memorial Stadium.
Yes, and as if that weren't bad enough, Mel, he'll have to do it right here in the Babe's backyard, where he hasn't had a home run all year.
So sit back, open a Valentine, because tonight could be history.
Batting third, center fielder Roger Maris.
Well, Phil, without Mantle batting behind him, I wonder if they'll pitch around Maris.
Well, nobody wants to give up the big home run, but I gotta believe it's a matter of pride, and they'll pitch to him.
I certainly hope so.
Well, you know, I wouldn't, but hey, that's me. Okay, and here comes Maris. All eyes are on Raj, 58 home runs, but it's a nasty night here in Baltimore.
Come on, Raj!
Get a piece of it!
Get one!
Bill Pappas looks in. Here's the pitch.
Go, go, go!
That ball is high and deep to right field!
No. Oh, shit, the wind's got it!
It's going! It's going! To be gone!
It's gonna be a tough night.
Oh, guys, come on now. Let's
all right, Rod.
Shit. Now batting.
All right, here comes Roger. Blow out to right field his first time up. Now, I imagine someday someone will write about the month-long, day-in, day-out pressure on Roger Maris. Bill Pappas looks in. Here's the pitch. There's one. That ball is high and deep and into the wind. Does it have enough?
Get out of here! Go, go, go,
go! That ball is going. Going. It is gone!
Yeah! Damn it. Son of a bitch.
I haven't missed anything, not at all. No, he came up the first time and flied out.
The kids were sick. I didn't know where to go,
and
then I got lost.
12-59.
No, I didn't.
How about that?
He's got 2 more at-bats, maybe 3.
What, all of a sudden you're back on his side?
He's only one shy now, folks. My, number 59. Don't go anywhere.
What happened? I was in the jump. Slider, huh?
Yeah, it didn't slide, though.
It was a good one.
Now batting, left fielder, Yogi Berra.
Hall struck out Maris in the 6th, but he's got another shot here in the 7th.
Well, and Hall's got that crazy sidearm delivery. It's very tough to beat. What a swing by Maris. Boy, I tell you, every pitch could be the one.
One time, Raj.
Holy cow, number 60.
Ghost for pushing it back.
No! I thought he had it. Too bad. The way Hall's pitching tonight, he'll never get another at bat. It's over.
Oh, what a shame. And to go out that way, boy, so close. The wind just held it up. But any other night, that's out of here. So, unless the Yanks get a rally here, Roger doesn't have a chance to get the 60th in 154 games, Mel. We'll see what happens.
Left fielder.
That's all we can do.
All right, let's go. We're going to start. Let's start. Come on, Yogi. Come on, Yogi.
folks. Top of the ninth, Yanks up 4-2. Two outs and on the verge of clinching the pennant, but nobody's thinking about that. All eyes are on Roger Maris.
Oh, you said it, Mel. What a story. The Yanks get a rally to get Roger another at bat. And I tell you, something's going to happen here. I could just feel it.
I'm going to make a change.
Time? Time is up!
What's this? Time out on the field?
What the hell is going on?
I think it's time we call it a night. Good job.
They're making a pitching switch. Whoa, the man with the nastiest pitch in baseball, Hoyt Wilhelm.
Your attention, please.
They're bringing in Wilhelm. He'll come in unless they got to leave. What is this?
Bullshit.
Son of a bitch is bringing him in just to face Raj.
No, this is Bush.
Come on, it's a good move.
Smuck.
Folks, I got to tell you, that knuckleball, that is one. Woo.
Look at this, they're bringing in the big glove. What, do you need help? Hate that knuckleball.
And this weather's going to be dancing all over the place.
Oh, even if he gets wood on it, it's not going anywhere.
Bush Leaguer!
All right, boy, here's the deal.
You give Maris a fastball, I'll find your ass $5,000, you hear me? Just give me a ball. Go get him.
Oh, boy, Mel, I hated knuckleballers. That pitch is something. I mean, it's got no spin, so it dances, it floats. You don't know where it's going to go.
Let's play ball!
So what's this guy throwing?
All right, here we go, folks.
Roger Maris with one final shot at tying the Babe, and he's facing the man with the single toughest pitch in baseball. Wilhelm takes the sign, but we all know what's coming. Does Roger Maris have one last home run in him? Oh, he fouled it back. Roger had a good cut on that ball, but it's dancing all over the place. All right, here's the 0-1.
Check it off. Three outs for clinch. Let's go. Go.
Let's go. Come on, so that's it, folks. A valiant effort by Roger Maris, but he'll fall one shy of the record. How about that?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Maris.
I shouldn't have moved my chair. Jinxed it.
Gave it a hell of a shot.
Yeah, pressure got to him there.
Marty, you ever play baseball?
No, not really.
That's what I thought.
Hey, Rog. We just want to say we're proud to be your teammates.
Perhaps it may sound corny, but my biggest sports thrill in 1961 was seeing Roger Maris hit a weak squib to Hoyt Wilhelm. Maris's failure to break Babe Ruth's record evokes no great regret here.
If the record is to be broken, it should be done by someone of greater baseball stature, greater color and public appeal.
Maris is no more than a good big league ball player. He's colorless, he's never hit 300, and is often surly. There just isn't anything deeply heroic about the man.
Is there something to be said about fate on this gloomy night in Baltimore? Did that last knuckleball flutter just past the sweet spot? Did the spirit of Babe Ruth stir those gusting winds? Or was Roger Maris denied because he just wasn't what we wanted? Maybe some records aren't made to be broken.
Congratulations,
it over?
No, it's tough.
You got to be disappointed with that check swing, though, huh?
Yeah, but Wilhelm's a hell of a pitcher, you know. He's got a great knuckleball, so.
Roger.
Hey,
who do you want to play in the series?
I'm not even thinking about that right now. We got another 8 games to play, Jim.
You can put 2 more out, maybe?
Well, I don't know, you know. It's luck of the draw, so. I'm just happy to be playing ball.
Right, let me ask you one more question.
I can't believe you got a suite.
Yeah. Oh, there you are.
Thank you, sir. You gonna wear that hat all night?
No, it's just,
Let me see.
No.
You're just molting.
See the view? It's real nice. It's Central Park out there.
Yeah, I know. It's beautiful.
Yeah, real nice.
Oh, I got some pictures of Randy.
Yeah?
Some new ones. He is growing so fast. A picture of Susan when she lost her tooth.
Goodbye. Didn't do it.
All right, listen up. Serv's recovering from his surgery. He's done for the year. And we had to put Mickey in the hospital today, too. His hips, it's in real bad shape. And hopefully we'll have him for the series. If not, we're just going to have to pick up the slack. Now, we got 5 games left, so let's just make sure we stay sharp. All right?
Let's do it for
Mick.
No, just you have it. No, put it back.
Bob,
about
the button.
Shh,
button.
Can I?
Stop, right there. You got it.
Come on,
Roger. Come on, Roger. Come on,
Roger. All right.
Your husband's a terrific ball player.
Thank you.
I'm sure the Babe would have been happy it was another Yankee.
No, I don't think Babe would have been happy at all. Babe loved this record.
Well, it's nice of you to be here.
The center field of number 9. Roger Maris, number 9.
Maris playing center today because Mantle, of course, is in the hospital with 54 home runs, and I'm sure he's looking on, and we wish Mickey all the best. But today, all eyes are on Maris. There it is!
No!
Come on, to the back!
What do you want from me, Mickey?
Up a deck for Roger Maris, number 60 for Raj. So now 2 men have hit 60 home runs in a single season, both Yankees, Roger Maris, and of course the late Babe Ruth. And Bill, he's got 4 more games to hit that 61st. My.
Number 60, 1 more.
Oh, this is getting interesting.
Will Roger bop the Babe? After hitting his 60th home run, Yankee right fielder Roger Maris has failed in 3 games to hit the elusive 61st. Try as he may, the slugging right fielder couldn't put one into the seats. And now it's down to 1 final game. Will it be Roger over and out? We'll find out this Sunday.
You know the difference between hitting a home run and popping up is 1/8 of an inch? Probably less. God, Pat, I don't know where my swing's gone in the last three games. I just can't seem to hit the ball.
Maybe you're just trying too hard.
Yeah, maybe. You know, if I hit one tomorrow, the ball's gonna be worth $5,000.
$5,000 for a ball.
Believe that?
Oh my God, it'll be a madhouse.
Yeah. I want to do it. You know, I may not count to everybody else, but I'll know. I'm gonna hit that home run. You'll be there.
Hello, everybody. This is Mel Allen. Well, you couldn't have asked for a more dramatic finish to an incredible season. Last game, last chance for Roger Maris. Will it be 61-61? We'll find out today.
Yeah, well, I got the heebie-jeebies here, Mel. I'll tell you, I can't imagine what Maris is going through.
Look at this crowd. It's pathetic.
Well, grandstand's filled. Everybody's looking for that $5,000.
Is Frick coming? I spoke to his office. They said he was out of town. What about Mrs. Ruth?
I think she had enough the other day.
Pathetic.
And here he comes.
Only 23,000 fans here to see this.
Come on, Raj. Here we go.
Roger Maris comes to the plate for the second time. They're getting busy in right field.
Just like it was his first.
Payment on a house.
Hey,
don't you think that ball belongs to Roger or maybe in the Hall of Fame?
Oh, yeah. No, fellas, I don't care about the ball. Sal, you sell it, do what you like, get your money.
Thanks.
Roger, are you serious? You really don't care about the ball?
No, I don't need the ball. He could use it more than I could.
Roger, how about the asterisk, Roger? You think that's all right?
Well, I don't know, Sam. It's just not my decision.
Roger,
what do you think about the crowd today? They give you a lot of support out there.
Yeah, that was really nice. Yeah.
Roger, do you think you earned their respect holding up under all this pressure?
Oh, gosh. I don't know, Milt. I really don't think that's something you earn on a ball field.
Raj, what about next year? You think you can do it again?
How are you, pal?
Hey. Congratulations.
Thanks.
That was great.
Thanks, man. Boy, this is some nice joint they got you in here.
Oh, thanks.
Where's Bob?
Oh, he's in his room clipping his toenails or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was pretty crazy, huh?
Oh, man, the place just nuts.
I saw the guys as pushing you out of the dugout.
Yeah, they wouldn't let me back in, so...
I thought I saw you smiling there a little bit.
Oh, yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, I caught you.
Yeah. That was something else.
Yeah. Oh. Wish I was there.
Yeah, we all did. It just didn't seem right without you, Mick.
Oh, why aren't you out celebrating?
Oh, me and Pat were gonna go to Shores for dinner and... I just figured I'd see how you're doing. Wondering if the doctors are going to have you ready for the series.
Oh, I don't know. I hope so. I hate it here. The damn nurses that wake you up to give you a sleeping pill. I hate watching you guys on the tube.
You would have done it, too. You know that.
Bullshit. It was you, Raj. You did it. You son of a bitch. And nobody can ever take that away from you, neither. No matter what bullshit they try to tell you, that record's yours. You're a good man, Roger. Fastball, right?
Fastball, yeah. I guess it wasn't fast enough.
You got good wood on that.
Oh, man. It felt good, Mick.
I do know the feeling.
Greatest season of my life. Wouldn't want to do it again.
Thank you.
family watching from their seats. And now here comes Sammy Sosa in to congratulate Mark McGwire. What a classy move. Two men from completely different backgrounds with this home run chase. It's Mark McGwire who gets to the top of the mountain first. Home run number 62 in the Cardinals' 145th game of the year. Well, mixed emotions, I'm sure, for the Maris kid. Sorry to see the record fall, but on the other hand, grateful for the fame this season has brought their father.
As I went over to the box and talked to Roger's kids, I told them today when I met with the Hall of Fame, they pulled out Roger's bat that when he hit his 61st home run, and I touched it. I touched it with my heart. Now I can honestly say that my bat will lie next to his, and I'm damn proud of it.
The separate single-season home run records remained until 1991, when Fay Vincent, the commissioner of baseball, ordered that there be only one record. Roger Maris died 6 years earlier, never knowing that the record belonged to him.
Mickey Mantle, son. And that's a home run.
Thank you.